What up guys, this is TheSighBored here. Once again, we have the KYT TTC helmet with us. And this is not going to be a review, helmet review video. If you want to check out the review, it's already on the channel, so you can go check that one out, no props. So what is this video about? For this video, if you have watched the previous one, this video is about the accessories or modifications that I did to the TTC. And I'm just going to share some feedback on what are the accessories I put on and how do they fare or how do they function. So straight up, just a quick 360 for you guys, right? This is the KYT TTC Course Matte Black, which I have. So straight up, I'm going to start with the back. The back will be this piece here, okay? This is going to be the 3D spoiler, I think, something like that, which I got it from Shopee. All right, all the accessories I got for this helmet are from Shopee. The links will be in the channel description, so you can go check it out if you want to. So straight up, for this spoiler, okay, I'm not sure whether it's original or not. And from the looks of it, if you can see, it really extends the actual existing spoiler. So in terms of the looks, if you see the back part of the helmet section here, the looks is actually really good, okay? Very like a swept back, elongated feel for it. So it looks really good. Now comes to the performance. So how did it perform? I did some high speed runs and I can say that it didn't perform to expectation. The standard spoiler itself had a little bit of head shaking at higher speeds. This one, I feel it added more, a little bit more to that. So the other thing was also when you start turning your head, all right, when you shift your head to look left or right, this spoiler actually catches more wind. So you actually feel your head being dragged when you are turning your head to look sideways and so on. My verdict will be for this spoiler, gaya memang terbaik, looks awesome, okay? But functionality, I would say it's not there. So if you're hoping that this will stabilize the helmet, give you better aerodynamics, I don't think so. But if you are not a fast rider, let's say you are not going over 150, you're just cruising maybe 100 plus, I think the spoiler won't affect you that much, okay? It's mainly for the higher speeds where you will start noticing the wind drag and a little bit of the pressure on the top part of your head. So that's about the spoiler. The next thing that I did was this thing here, which is modifying the glass to the smoke glass. So the visor itself came with the standard clear. We have gotten the smoked one. Whether it's original, again, I'm not certain, but I think this might not be original. And one of the guys that actually contacted me also bought from the same Shopee person and so on. He said that the visor, when you clip it fully locked down and try to open it, it actually is a little bit tough or a little bit like stuck, you know, like a little bit thick. So at first I said like, yeah, I do notice the same thing, but I didn't feel it's a big issue because if it's a tight fit, like, you know, you need some force to close it, but I can still open it with one hand. So that's okay for me. And I think if it's tight, probably maybe the waterproof will be better since the seal is tighter, I guess. Optics of the visor is good. I have no problems. The tint of the visor, I feel is okay. Although they say it's dark smoke, I don't think this is that dark. So it's okay for me. Overall, I'm happy with the visor, but I just need to point out that, again, the last bit where you lock down the visor, it will be a little bit tough to open, okay? So that will be about the visor. The third item that I got is actually not displayed here on the helmet right now. That will be the antifog insert, all right? This visor has antifog inserts, pin lock post, right? These white things here. But I cannot put the antifog on this visor. So let me talk about the antifog insert itself. Again, originality from pin lock, I don't think so. So if you're asking me why I'm not buying original stuff, it's not because I don't want to, it's because I'm not sure where to get them from. So I just see what's on Shopee and I just give it a try out. So again, the antifog insert itself, the functionality, I will start on that first. It actually works pretty good. Okay, I tried to put in some warm water with the water vapor coming up and to check whether it fogs up, it mists up, and it didn't. Okay, so I'm happy to report that the antifog fits properly to the visor and it works properly as intended. The optics for the antifog, when you put it double layer with your visor and the antifog behind it, is actually okay. Alright, I didn't feel like any sort of vision distortions and so on. So the antifog itself, I would say, is a good buy. Okay. However, if you're asking me why didn't I put it on this, so here comes the trick. So as I said, this visor might be a little bit thick and the fit is a little bit tight. So when I put the antifog on this visor, this smoke visor, it takes a lot of effort to close it. Okay. And it's practically impossible to open this visor with the antifog insert with one hand. So I literally need to grab the helmet with one hand and use another hand to pop the visor open. And that also I need to give it a lot, it's a crazy amount of force to pop it open. So therefore, I feel like the antifog on this visor, it's just not practical, because if I put the visor down, there's no way I can lift the visor up with one hand. That's why I decided to put the antifog on the original clear visor, and that one actually worked fine. Okay, so with the original clear visor and the antifog on it, it can open and close fine. So that's why we are leaving it at that. So this is just a short video about the three modifications that I've done. Each part that I got for is about, on average, I would say maybe around 50 ringgit each. You can go and check out the links, like I said. So I hope this has been informative. Before I end the video, I do know that there's one, breath scoop. It's something you install on the front part of the helmet here. It's supposed to direct airflow to you better or something like that. But I feel it just looks too weird for me having that scoop. I know the RI helmet has it. If you watch the MotoGP guys, the RI helmet has that transparent thing, but I just don't gel with it. So that's why I didn't get that breath scoop or air scoop, whatever, for the front here. So that's about it. Overall, I'm pretty happy with my buys. Just that I feel a bit disappointed that I cannot fit the antifog on this smoke visor. And so if you're getting a smoke visor, I think if you try to get fully original, probably you won't have this problem. So that's it for me for this video. I hope you enjoy it. I'll definitely be back for more. So till then, this is TheSighBored here. Ride safe and safe ride.